in Oromia State. A member of the opposition party OLF witnessed the recent protests that were crushed by authorities.
There were protests of Oromo earlier, and this situation led many people to be hit by the soldier of this dictator government, and many were killed or shot by the police and the military of the government.
The majority of Ambo's population is ethnic Oromo. Soldiers stand guard at the university, where protests have been met with violence. Demonstrators don't want to be seen speaking on camera here, so they propose a meeting place outside the city. This woman says she was hit on the head with a gas grenade. A man says his scars are from an attack by the military.
In Ethiopia, they have no democracy. So these people is no have problems. It is in case of asking their rights and democratic demonstrations. In case of democratic demonstration, then attack by gun.
While they're still speaking, Yazo notices a group of men he believes are government spies.
Look, these are no civilians.
To keep the witnesses out of harm's way, we stop filming and leave the city.
In Ambo, the military usually wears uniform, but there are also those who do not wear the military uniform and who seems a civil worker. Many of them are spying the people.
Back in the capital, Addis Ababa, the Human Rights Council confirms these accusations in writing. Going on record, on camera, is too dangerous for this local organization. Those who question government policies are subject to violence and repression. The opposition says ethnic Oromo are routinely oppressed.
This protest originally is not a protest against the diversification of Addis Ababa. Rather, this protest is a protest of freedom. They want to snatch our land, our culture, our language. This is what we call the assimilation colonial system.
Over 3.5 million people live in the rapidly growing capital of Ethiopia. But even a withdrawal of the government's plan to expand Addis Ababa would not resolve the tensions, according to the opposition. For that to happen, it says, the ruling elite's harsh treatment of the ethnic Oromo must come to an end.